All right, hello students. Today we are going to begin our pig dissection. And in our laboratory book, you can find this in lab 13. It's always good to have the instruments out that you're going to be using, and we have labels here for each of those. The first thing that I'm gonna do is show you how to load your scalpel handle so that we can make our incisions. The first thing you are going to need is your scalpel handle. And then you are gonna need your blade. So when you are going to use your blade, it's important to appreciate that this is a sharp instrument. So you're going to peel this open kind of like a banana, and you don't want to be touching the sharp aspect of the blade itself. Then you can either take your needle drivers or hemostats, depending on what type of instruments you have available, and you're gonna grasp the alternate side to the sharp edge of the blade. And you wanna clamp down so it locks so this doesn't slide within your needle drivers. Then you are going to load the blade onto the scalpel handle. To do that, you wanna make sure these two angles right here actually match up. So this is the appropriate direction to slide this on. And you can see on the scalpel handle, we have grooves right here. We're gonna be fitting this part of the blade into those grooves. So you're gonna set it into the wide area here and then slide it on just like that. And you wanna make sure this is down and nice and tight. If you want to remove the blade, you will aim it into your rubber padding so it doesn't go anywhere. You lift this up and just push it away like this. And then to load it, you're just gonna do the reverse. And I'm gonna switch my orientation here and slide that back on. And you wanna make sure that this is on nice and tight. So this is our scalpel blade, this is our scalpel handle, and we used our needle drivers, which have locking capability, to put that on. So when we begin our dissection, the first thing that we're gonna do is make a linear incision from the cervical area down to the pubic area. And we're gonna have to make some little detours here around the umbilical area. As you can see, when we're looking at this patient, we have the sheath here, so this is a male piggy, and we also have the scrotum back here, which is where the testicles will be. So we don't want to cut into the sheath and the penis, so we're going to cut around that. So as you make your incision, there's some very important neck structures in the cervical area and the thoracic area, so we want to be careful that we're only going through the skin right off the bat. And what helps me is extending the pig's neck and putting a little pressure on my first finger, and I'm gonna gently cut through the skin and extend my incision down towards the umbilicus. When I get to the umbilicus, again, I'm gonna make a skin incision around the sheath here. And this is gonna provide a flap of tissue that we can actually retract the sheath and keep the penis intact. We'll do this for the female as well, because you have to go around the umbilicus, and there are some umbilical structures that we're going to want to take a look at. So as we've made this incision, you can see here I've gone all the way through the skin here, and now I've got tissue that I want to move through here. The best way to get through tissue is you can use scissors and you can use your forceps. These are Brown Adson forceps. You can see the teeth right there. These are utility scissors and not ideal for tissue, but in the sense that we're using this for dissection and our patient is not live, this is acceptable. So what I'm gonna do is kind of open my scissors up, so extend them in and open them up, so I'm kind of separating this tissue away from the deep tissue. And in this way, I kind of protect my deeper structures here, and I can extend my incision a little bit cranially or superiorly, okay? So now as I go, as I move down here, I'm gonna wanna lift this tissue up and cut, and I'm just gonna do this all along my incision here, okay? And down at the abdomen as well. So again, lifting up and just making little cuts so I don't necessarily cut through my organs. So you can see here, I've cut through the peritoneum right here into the abdomen, and so now I can lift this up and extend my incision cranially up towards the ribs here. And these scissors actually will cut through the ribs. You can also use your bone cutters here. So this is another instrument if you need to do that. This will kind of dull these, but this is actually fairly easy to cut through right here. So I'm now cutting through the thoracic cavity, through the sternum, and I'm extending my incision cranially. We've got some cervical muscles here. So what I'm looking for in the neck is going to be these two muscles right here. I don't know if you can see them, but right there we've got some muscles, and I'm gonna separate that out so you can kind of use your scissors to separate that. And right below that is the gold mine right there. That is going to be my thyroid. So this is really important. You can see how superficial this is. If I had cut any deeper, I would have cut into the thyroid itself. Another anatomical landmark that can be very helpful is this firm structure right here. This is my larynx, or the piggy's larynx. Okay, this is our fetal pig larynx. So just below the larynx, we have the thyroid, and you can take some time and dissect this out. Okay, I'm just gonna do a little bit right here. So we can see, and of course, this thyroid is sitting right over this ring structure here, which is the trachea. Good. Additionally, for your pigs, you are gonna want to extend this incision a little more cranially, and also dissect the tissue to the left of the larynx and the trachea. And down in this space is where you're going to find, posterior to the trachea, we're going to find the esophagus. Okay, so I'm going to spend some time clearing that out. I'll do that in a minute. I want to extend our incision further back here for you. And again, I'm lifting up my tissue so I don't cut the tissue below. Okay, so we're cutting through abdominal muscles. We're cutting through the peritoneum. We've already cut through the skin. And we're extending our incision caudally. And again, trying to lift up here. There is a structure right here. This is going to be the umbilical vein. Okay, so this is taking fluid, blood from the placenta to the heart. And we've got our bladder here and umbilical arteries here. So we want to make sure we don't cut those. So that's why I'm kind of separating this out and being very careful in this area here. Okay. Now, when I'm going to need to retract this tissue here with the penis and the sheath and the bladder attached here. And so I'm going to have to cut this umbilical vein. What I would like you to do is cut it in the middle so you can see where it actually attached. And then this way you can retract this piece right here, and we can see the bladder and the umbilical arteries. Okay, so getting our abdomen set up, this is how we're going to do this. I'm going to spend a couple of minutes and we'll fast forward here, and I'll just clean everything up, and then we'll go over some important tissues. All right, students, to see the structures in the mouth and to be able to visualize the epiglottis and the hard palate and the soft palate, we're gonna have to open up some structures in the mouth. You can appreciate that we are not gonna be able to do this very easily without making some incisions. I caution you, when you are handling the mouth of the pigs, these teeth right here are very, very sharp. So you can actually puncture through your gloves and cause injury. So be very careful when handling the jaw of the pig. We are going to make two incisions on the lateral aspects of the jaw. So we're gonna cut through the buccal tissue, and we're actually gonna have to cut through and disarticulate the jaw. This is not pretty, but it will give us some visualization to the epiglottis, and it will allow us to be able to see those structures. Why is this important? If you're going into the medical field or you want to know about anatomy, understanding the opening to the trachea and the esophagus is very important. You may have to use the bone cutters to cut through the jaw here because this is pretty thick, okay? And so we have to disarticulate this piece to be able to see the epiglottis. So we're kind of moving back here. Again, this is not super pretty. I apologize. So this will give us visualization of the epiglottis here. If we go through these folds, you'll see the vocal folds here. Very hard to get this separated out. But if we have two instruments, I'm going to need more hands to show you. But you can actually see vocal folds here. This is going to be the entrance to trachea, and esophagus will be posterior. Additionally, you can see here hard palate, soft palate, and we can actually see the nasopharynx up in here. So this goes to the nasal cavity. So I'm actually going in there. So this will give you an idea for your respiratory labs. You're going to be looking at these structures. Digestive labs, you're going to be looking at these structures.